She went from me too to me who. She doesn't care. She doesn't care. She's like, oh, Joe Biden, whatever it takes. Get creepy, sleepy, Beijing, Biden, Joe China in there at all costs, okay?
Kimberly, I wanted to get your thoughts on this. So the presumptive Democratic nominee, Joe Biden, he's had the sexual assault allegations claims made against him. How do you think the media has treated him?
Yeah, I mean, it's just unbelievable. They literally are just like, they cover their eyes, they put their hands like under their seat, and they don't want to write about it, they don't want to talk about it, they don't see it. It's a total double standard. It's grossly hypocritical. It's insulting. It's offensive to women. It's offensive to victims of sexual assault, which I take very seriously as a former sexual assault and domestic violence prosecutor. Really, look at you people, how rich. The fact that you could sit there and try to tear down and destroy an innocent man and Brett Kavanaugh, but yet somebody with really persuasive, corroborative evidence to show that this, in fact, did occur with her making what we call a fresh complaint about it back in the time to people who were right there. And she told them about what happened and making the complaints about it. And all of a sudden, Joe Biden, it's just he can do whatever he wants. That no harm, no foul. And you see this hypocrisy, especially with like Hollywood celebrities and like the Alyssa Milanos of this world. It's totally phony. It's a joke. It's a joke, and no woman should be wanting to support Joe Biden.
Which brings
believe all women unless they're going against a Republican. And we, you know, I mean that, and that's what it is. I mean, all these people, whether it's the Me Too movement, to just turn a blind eye to this, to pretend that doesn't exist in a literally a one-sided type argument. When you look at what they tried to do to Brett Kavanaugh, Brett Kavanaugh's high school yearbook was totally fair game as far as they're concerned. Right. His high school yearbook. But Joe Biden's Senate papers from decades representing the American people, okay, paid for by the American public. No, that's off limits. I mean, think about how ridiculous this whole standard is, and all of them, all the people vying to be VP, all of the things they said about Kavanaugh, you put their quotes in the Joe Biden context with substantially more corroborating evidence because they had exactly zero on Brett Kavanaugh. So here they have substantial corroborating evidence going back 30 years. Okay. But nothing to see here. Well, it's different. It's absolutely disgusting and they should be ashamed of themselves.
Which brings me to the former gubernatorial candidate from Georgia. That would be Stacey Abrams, who's all in supporting Biden. In fact, she is doing a show with him on MSNBC. And as I recall, she was a big advocate for the Me Too movement. She was one of the faces against Kavanaugh. Do you find that a little bit hypocritical?
Of course. Listen, no one has campaigned to be someone's vice president more than Stacey Abrams has for Joe Biden. I mean, she's, you know, practically beating him to death in the public, you know, that he better, you know, choose her. So, you know, again, it just goes to show you can say all of those things. You can be VP, but now I'm running for VP. Right. So it's a little bit different. We're just going to put that aside and pretend that it never happened. Give me a break, people.
That's what it is.
Give
so me a she
break.
Went from me too to me who. She doesn't care. She doesn't care. She's like, oh, Joe Biden, whatever it takes. Get creepy, sleepy, Beijing, Biden, Joe China in there at all costs, okay? So, you know, she's probably having dreams at night about how, like, maybe halfway in she could replace him. I mean, I think it's ridiculous. And these people really have no credibility whatsoever. When you really look at the facts, you look at the evidence, and what are Joe Biden's accomplishments? Why is anyone even voting for him? Or yeah, it's a big fat zero. 50 years of ripping off the American taxpayers while he was asleep at the wheel. The guy doesn't even know that he's like running for president. He's like, someone wake me up. Is the Senate race today? He has no idea. And America deserves better than that. They deserve President Donald Trump, who will get us out of this mess, and he will bring the American economy back roaring again. How do we know? He did it once before. Joe Biden, nothing. This is just more of the failures of the administration of Barack Obama, okay? And where they like to do deals like the Iran deal, you know, subsidizing state sponsors of terrorism and driving up taxes and accomplishing nothing.